On Motoring Forum this week, we are fortunate to have our first interview with the head of the LTFRB under the new administration, Chairman Martin Delgra. And we hope to get some insight from his good self regarding some current transport issues. Good afternoon, Chairman Delgra, and welcome to Motoring Today.
Good afternoon, Butch, and to all the viewers of Motoring Today.
As a starter, being new in your position as LTFRB Chairman, would you kindly afford our viewers a brief background of yourself, including your past government service, if any?
It's actually my first time to join government upon the invitation of President Duterte. Before that, I've been in the private practice of law for 26 years now running. So I've been a lawyer for a long time based in Davao and helping out in some of the concerns with the mayor, then Mayor Duterte. So that's how I was able to get to know him more closely. And here in LTFRB, having to head this agency, I have the task to clean the agency, as what the president has been saying repeatedly over the past several weeks, because this is among the most corrupt agency in government, being a regulatory body. And we have been doing that in all the regional visits that we have conducted. However, in addition, and more importantly, we need to improve the efficiency of the delivery in government service, especially in the issuance of franchises, because that is our main role in this agency.
We thank you for that, Mr. Chairman. Now, may I proceed to the first issue at hand, which inevitably concerns the traffic in the metropolis and which also greatly concerns your office. Reports have it that the so-called UV Express, which was initially viewed by your agency as contributory to the traffic volume in EDSA and therefore was banned from traversing it, would again be allowed to ply EDSA. May we know your stand on this?
Actually, in the first place, traffic is never a mandate of this agency, nor of the Department of Transportation. Pero inako na lang namin, no, headed by Secretary Tugade, that we will be able, that we take and share the responsibility of addressing the traffic situation or traffic congestion in Metro Manila. It is in a crisis proportion that we need everyone to get involved to address the crisis. And that's precisely why we're actually pushing Congress also to grant us special powers to address this crisis. It's more specifically to address the traffic congestion, not only in Metro Manila, but also in other major cities, including Cebu and Davao. In the case of the UV Express that you mentioned, we are looking at EDSA being a highway to invest more on what we call high-capacity buses. And having said that, kung merong mga buses na, then we are not to allow the other modes of transport, no? Kung kakayanin ng mga buses. Now, initially, we took out the UV Express from EDSA, but we noted that some of these UV Express especially are coming from the provinces, and they nakiusap sila, lalo na yung galing sa probinsya, na kung pwede, dumaan ng EDSA only to pass through EDSA, but not to drop and pick passengers along EDSA. So, ibig sabihin, tuloy-tuloy yung daloy ng traffic ng mga UV Express pupunta ng EDSA, hindi nahihinto. At saka, only in shorter intervals. I'm talking about, for example, from the Balintawak Express going to North SM, North SM or Trinoma, which is just a short distance of about 2 or 3 kilometers apart.
Now, since time immemorial, and I'm witness to this, having been exposed to this problem in our 3 decades of having this TV show, the presence of illegal or out-of-line POVs, or what's commonly called colorums, had always been a big contributory factor in the volume of vehicles in the metro and its traffic problems. All of the past LTFRB administrations have ventured to stop their proliferation, and all, and I mean all, have failed. I'm sure you have no intentions of joining their ranks. Now, where is the LTFRB now in this campaign? That is, if there is any.
Now, as regards Colorum, or the campaign against Colorum vehicles for that matter, we would recall what President Duterte said during his SONA, or State of the Nation address. He mentioned exactly that the campaign against Colorum will continue and it will be relentless. No? But even before the SONA of July, the third week of July, tuloy-tuloy yung kampanya namin against Colorum vehicles, and even until now. No? So araw-araw, nadadagdagan yung mga Colorum vehicles na nai-impound dito sa opisina namin. In fact, yung mga ibang mga sasakyan are already parked along East Avenue. No? At saka yung about 30 or 40 of the vehicles are already out in Tarlac, where they're actually impounded as well. However, yung Colorum, the campaign against Colorum vehicles are not only concentrated in Metro Manila. When the president so directed that the campaign against Colorum vehicles will continue and will be relentless, nagpatupad din kami ng office order directing all regional offices to conduct similar operations against Colorum. No? In fact, mas matindi pa nga yung level of threats ng mga enforcers natin doon sa region. No? But nevertheless, they were able to perform well. No? So as of last week, we were able to apprehend 354 Colorum vehicles all over the country. Half of that mostly were taken in Metro Manila area.
Now, we heard that there's a very strong move to phase out POVs that are 15 years old and older. Are you supporting this, and what is the status of the venture?
Okay, as regards the 15-year-old policy for public utility vehicles, the direction of the Department of Transportation is the same. We will continue towards the same direction of phasing out old and dilapidated units of public utility vehicles. We are starting with the buses, and in fact, we're very strict about the buses. So, pag darating na yung punto na 15 years na yung old yung buses, kailangan palitan na ng bago. We know that yung PUVs marami at pangangailangan pa rin, no, in terms as a mode of public transport, lalo na sa mga probinsya. Kaya we're looking at a phase-out program that would be spread out, no, insofar as the PUV is concerned. But as I've said, the direction there is really to phase out old and dilapidated units. Why? Because our mandate is to provide safe and convenient and dependable public transportation system. And the only way to go is to improve the kind of public motor vehicles that are given franchises by this agency.
Now, related to this phase-out of 15-year-old POJs, owners and collectors of classic and vintage cars are hauling in protest against a fast poised move to include their priceless historical possessions in this phase-out. What's your stand on this?
Actually, insofar as the classic cars are concerned, I would say that they are considered private vehicles. No? So, hindi yan masasali dito sa, insofar as LTFRB is concerned, that they would be prohibited from getting franchises, because in the first place, they won't get any because these are what you call private vehicles. Insofar as the 15-year-old phase-out policy is concerned, and insofar as LTFRB is concerned, we're looking at public utility vehicles.
Are there any major change in policy or introduction of new ones in your administration of the LTFRB?
Now, insofar as the issue of Colorum is concerned, it's actually directly related to the moratorium in the issuance of new franchises all over the country. And the moratorium has been in place for more than 10 years. And because of that, there's been in a number of places all across the country a need for public transport. Ibig sabihin, mataas yung demand ng public transport. And because hindi natutugunan dahil sa moratorium na yan, kaya na, there has been a proliferation of colorum vehicles. We are addressing that now, no? The decade-long moratorium will soon be lifted. But we're going to lift it in a rational, comprehensive, and calibrated manner. No? So that hopefully soon, we're looking at a timetable before the end of the year to lift the moratorium so that the needs of the public, insofar as public transport is concerned, would be addressed.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Chairman. Before we end, do you have any message to our viewers?
Now, insofar, I would just like to state it, you know, that when we took office, the mandate has been to clean this agency. And we're doing that, no? Even as we speak. And in fact, we're going around the country, conducting regional visits, not only to meet with the employees in the regional offices, but also to reach out and engage stakeholders, particularly operators, public utility operators, you know, to shout out, to help the agency, to help the government get rid of corruption in this agency. Kasi hindi naman pwede na, if they will allow themselves, I'm referring to the operators, no, to be victimized, or they themselves will participate in this form of corruption, eh wala talagang mangyayari. And if I will know that they are into corruption, rest assured, I will deny your application. No? Nakapagtataka nga to hear from the operators na yung prangkisa pala ay walang bayad. Kasi narinig namin, and nanggagaling din sa mga operators, na malalaki yung mga bayad nila sa mga prangkisa na kinukuha nila sa mga regional offices. So, nagtaka sila, pati ako nagtaka, na nagbabayad sila ng malaki, nagtaka rin sila na may bayad din pala. No? Pero yung iba talaga, nagbabayad dahil akala nila na makuha nila yung prangkisa nila sa pag na manunuhol sila sa mga opisyales ng ahensya namin. We should stop that. No? We should stop that.
Thank you once again for this opportunity to have you on our program, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Butch, and happy motoring.
Chairman Martin Delgra of the LTFRB, our guest this week on Motoring Today's Motoring Forum.